हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर राजीव गुप्ता वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन श्रीमती एमडी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फिजिकल साइंस एंड रिसर्च आनंद। द कोर्स नेम इज़ एमएससी ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। द सेमेस्टर इज़ फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर। द सब्जेक्ट इज़ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री फर्स्ट एंड इट्स सब्जेक्ट कोड इज PS01 CCHE22। द यूनिट नंबर इज 1 विच इज स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन स्यूडो किरेलिटी एंड प्रो स्टीरियो आइसोमेरिज्म इन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। सो स्यूडो किरेलिटी और स्यूडो एसिमेट्रिक कार्बन एटम और स्यूडो किरेल सेंटर। सो व्हाट इज स्यूडो किरेल सेंटर? दिस स्यूडो एसिमेट्रिक टर्म इज अ ट्रेडिशनल नेम फॉर अ टेट्राहेड्रली कोऑर्डिनेटेड कार्बन एटम बॉन्डेड टू फोर डिफरेंट एंटिटीज। सो इफ अ कार्बन एटम इज बॉन्डेड विथ फोर डिफरेंट एंटिटीज देन वी कैन कॉल इट अ किरेल सेंटर। बट In these four different entities, two and only two of which have the same constitution but opposite chirality sense. Means a pseudo asymmetric center or a pseudo chiral carbon is that carbon atom which has four different entities, but here two different entities will be exactly same constitutionally, but their chirality or their 3D arrangement will be different. So this carbon will be called as pseudo chiral carbon, and this property of this carbon atom or that molecule has pseudo chirality. The RS, that is small r and small s, descriptors of pseudo asymmetric carbon or pseudo chiral carbon atoms are invariant or on reflection in a mirror. Means if we see the mirror image of these type of molecules which have pseudo asymmetric center, then the RS configuration or RS descriptor will not change for that pseudo chiral center, which actually changes for a chiral center. If we see mirror image of a molecule, then the chiral centers which are present in that molecule will be changed. Their configuration, RS configuration, capital R or capital S configuration will be changed. But in case of this pseudo asymmetric carbon, this descriptor R or S will not change. R remains R and S remains S, but are reversed by the exchange of any two entities. Means any two entities on this tetrahedral coordinated carbon, if we exchange in odd number, then the configuration or the RS descriptor for that pseudo asymmetric carbon atom will be changed. Here R becomes S and S becomes R. As we can see in this diagram, in these two molecular structures, the configuration, or we can say the two entities, are interchanged. See, the above portion and this below portion is just same in this second structure, but the two entities which are hydrogen and OH groups are interchanged in this xyleric acid. So the configuration or RS descriptor for this pseudo chiral carbon will be changed. The examples are shown here. These are ribaric acid, this first one, and the second is xyleric acid. The carbon number 3 is pseudo chiral carbon or pseudo asymmetric carbon atom in this molecule. This सेकेंड नंबर कार्बन एटम इज कीरल कार्बन, दिस फोर्थ नंबर कार्बन एटम इज कीरल कार्बन, बट दिस थर्ड नंबर कार्बन एटम इज स्यूडो कीरल कार्बन, बिकॉज इन दिस फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ कार्बन एटम ऑल द फोर डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स आर एंटायरली डिफरेंट, कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली, सो दीज बोथ आर कीरल सेंटर्स, बट द थर्ड नंबर कार्बन एटम विच हैज टू डिफरेंट एंटिटीज विच आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली डिफरेंट, दीज एच एंड ओ एच ग्रुप्स, बट दीज होल ग्रुप्स सी एच ओ एच सी ओ एच एंड सी एच ओ एच सी ओ एच, दीज बोथ कंप्लीट ग्रुप्स आर एंटायरली सेम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनली, बट देयर कीरलिटी इज डिफरेंट. Maybe this second number carbon could be R or this fourth number carbon could be S, like this. So we will see here how we assign this pseudo chirality descriptor or RS to this pseudo chiral center. So see, let me take the pen. This second number carbon atom, which is chiral carbon atom, if we assign its RS configuration or its descriptor, then what we see, the oxygen will get, we use CIP nomenclature, CIP rules, this oxygen get will the priority first, this carbon atom of this carboxylic will get second, this is third, and this is fourth. Okay, so what we get using this chirality rule, arc 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, we get anti-clockwise movement, but our fourth number group, which is hydrogen, is present at this horizontal line, so we change our result. So actually this is R, the configuration, RS configuration or RS descriptor for this second number carbon atom in this molecule is R. Now see the configuration of this. Let me okay. Now here this will get first number, this second, this is third according to CIP rule, and this is fourth. Now 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, how we get, this is clockwise movement, but the fourth number lowest priority group situated at this horizontal line in this Fischer projection, so we will change our result, so it is S. So see, obviously these both chiral centers are have different chirality sense, different RS descriptor, different descriptors or different chirality sense. So actually these both groups, this group and this group, are constitutionally same, but their chirality is different. One is R and other is S. So this center carbon atom, which is third carbon atom in this molecule, is pseudo chiral center because the environment is actually different. These both entities H and OH are different constitutionally, but these both are different due to their chirality. So here what we get, how we assign R or S, which is small r or could be small s, how we will assign it, let me erase these things. So how we will assign our priority order according to obviously CIP rule. So first the priority will be for oxygen atom, because other are carbon, hydrogen and carbon, which are directly attached to this pseudo chiral carbon. So obviously oxygen will get number one, or hydroxyl group will get number one, and this hydrogen atom will get number four, the last priority, and this carbon are same, but actually the whole group is same, but their RS configuration is different. So here it is R and it is S. We know that according to CIP rule, R gets priority over S. So this carbon atom will get number 2. This carbon atom will get number 3 and this is 4. Now how we move 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So this is the movement, we can observe that it is anti-clockwise, but the fourth number priority group is situated at horizontal line, so we will reverse our result. So what we will get, that it is R, that is small r, not capital R. So for pseudo chiral centers or pseudo asymmetric carbon atoms, we assign these descriptors in small forms, small r or small s form. Okay, now if we observe this molecule here, we can see that these both molecules are diastereomeric relation. These both are diastereomers of each other, which are not mirror images. Here only the configuration is changed over this third number carbon atom in odd number, okay, and other configurations on these two chiral center are same as first one, as first molecule. So obviously this is R, it is S, okay, but here the positions are interchanged for hydroxyl and hydrogen group. So obviously how we will make numbering 1, this is 4, this is 2 and this is 3. So 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, now we get this clockwise movement, but the fourth number is present at this horizontal line. So reverse the answer and we will get small s. So here the configuration or descriptor is small r for this pseudo chiral center, but here it is small s. Okay, so here a odd number change is made in this zearalic acid. So ribaric acid contains this R and it contains S configuration. Generally the hyphen in pseudo asymmetric may be omitted. Generally we use hyphens for capital R and capital S, but we don't use these hyphens in case of small r and small s. So these are the pseudo chirality which are present in these molecules. So one thing was said here, that if reflection in a mirror is made, then R remains R and S remains S. So what is the meaning of this? Suppose we make reflection plane or a mirror image of this molecule. Suppose we put a mirror here, a mirror, then obviously we know that the chiral center configuration will be changed. The R will becomes S, this capital S becomes capital R. Okay, but see, in this mirror image this OH group will reflect at this side and this hydrogen group will reflect at this side, so the result will be same. So what we get, 1, this is 4, this is 2 and this is 3. So what we are getting, this clockwise rotation 1 to 2 to 2 to 3 in this mirror image. Okay, now reverse the answer, what we get, S, that this has a small s. So in this reflection in mirror, the configuration of, or we can say the descriptor, chirality descriptor, pseudo chirality descriptor for this pseudo chiral center will not change. Actually this makes change only for these chiral centers. Okay, now this is the second example of pseudo chiral center containing compound, which is ribitol. This ribitol contains a pseudo chiral center or pseudo chiral carbon. So first we see the definition. These definitions we already learned in a previous lecture. What is stereogenic center, what is chiral center. Okay, so these chiral centers are also stereogenic center, and this pseudo chiral center is also a stereogenic center, because if we interchange these two groups in odd number, then we get a new configuration or other credit descriptor. So this is also a stereogenic center, but it is not a chiral center, it is pseudo chiral center. So observe in this molecule, this is ribitol, where these both OH groups are situated at wedge position, and one this chiral center has R configuration and this chiral center has S configuration, RS. These both are chiral centers, so capital R and capital S are shown. So here this point we can see that this is a pseudo chiral center, okay, it is a pseudo chiral center because these H and OH both are different constitutionally, and these both portions are constitutionally same, these both portions, this portion and this portion constitutionally same, but their chirality is different, okay, it is R and it is S. So it is a pseudo chiral center or pseudo asymmetric center or pseudo asymmetric carbon atom. This carbon atom here is pseudo asymmetric carbon atom. So it is not chiral, but it is stereogenic. So as said earlier, that if we make mirror image of we see this molecule in mirror, then in this mirror image the configuration of these both chiral centers will be changed. R becomes S and S become R, but the configuration, or we can say the chirality or the descriptor, will not change for this pseudo chiral center, as it is S, small s here, and it is also S, small s, sorry, okay. So in this mirror image the configuration will not change on pseudo chiral center, but if we make its diastereomeric form, its diastereomer, then we can observe the change as I explained earlier. This R becomes S and S becomes R. So the configuration is changed. So what we see, the small s becomes small r. So this is a diastereomeric form of this ribitol, where the configuration on or chirality descriptor, pseudo chirality descriptor on this pseudo chiral center is changed. So here we do this, we solve this chirality descriptor for this pseudo chiral center according to CIP rules, okay. Now the another thing we have to read this, that this molecule is a meso compound. This ribitol is a meso compound. How is it is meso? We can see, let me erase this. We can observe that here a plane of symmetry is present. See, the half portion of this ribitol is exactly the mirror image of this half portion. Both are mirror image of each other, we can easily observe. Both OH groups on chiral centers, we can see that these are present on wedge, and here this plane is passing through. So the both parts are mirror image, so it is a meso compound, and its enantiomeric form, which is a mirror image of this, it is also a meso compound, okay. Also its diastereomeric form, which is drawn here, it is also a meso compound. Here we can observe a plane of symmetry. The another structure of this, the possible structure or stereoisomer of this ribitol molecule is shown here, where one OH group is present at wedge on this chiral carbon atom, and the another OH group present at dash on this second chiral carbon. So due to this, this plane of symmetry is lost. So this molecule actually a chiral molecule, okay. This is also a diastereomer of this meso compound, this achiral molecule. So it does not contain a plane of symmetry, okay. Here we cannot apply a plane of symmetry, though this is a chiral compound. Now what happens to this pseudo chiral center? Here the pseudo chiral center is lost, Now this central carbon atom, which is 1, 2, 3, third number carbon atom, it is not pseudo chiral in this optically active compound or chiral compound, where the configuration or chirality descriptor for both the chiral centers are same. Here it is S, or here it is also S. So both are same, means both are constitutionally same and both are same in chirality sense. So exactly the both groups are same. Now this carbon atom is not chiral and also not pseudo chiral. It is just a simple carbon atom. Okay. So this carbon is not chiral center, not stereogenic center, not pseudo asymmetric center, and this compound is not a meso compound. It is actually a optically active compound. Okay. Now if we make its mirror image, then obviously this mirror image is also optically active, or it is not meso, and here the configuration is changed on these two chiral centers. This SS becomes RR. Okay, and again here this central carbon atom obviously is not pseudo chiral center or not chiral center. So this is all about the pseudo chirality, pseudo asymmetric center or pseudo chiral center or carbon. Now come to the second topic of this lecture, which is pro stereo isomerism. The molecules which may show stereo isomerism if we made substitution on a substitution on a site, then they can form or can make or show stereoisomerism. So this is the initial form or pro form of these isomerisms. So we call this at a pro stereoisomerism. So what we are seeing here in this lecture, I am showing the topicity descriptor, means RS configuration. RS configuration, which is pro RS configuration or pro chirality descriptor for these pro chiral centers or pro chiral axis or pro chiral plane, means that molecules which are generally anisotropic, which may contain anisotropic ligands. In a other lecture I will explain these anisotropic ligands or this topicity topic in a very detail. Just here we can see that this type of molecule, as shown here, it contains a pro chiral carbon, a carbon which can be converted into chiral carbon by a single substitution. Okay, so here we can see that this carbon atom is attached four groups. This tetrahedral carbon is attached with these four groups, and these two groups are exactly same. Both are hydrogen atoms. Okay, both are hydrogen atoms, so both are same. So actually this carbon is not a chiral carbon, it is a simple carbon atom, ordinary carbon atom. But if we replace or substitute any one of these two hydrogen atoms, if we replace HA or if we replace HB, then we will get a chiral carbon. This carbon atom, this tetrahedral carbon atom, will be converted into a chiral carbon atom. So it is a pro condition of chirality. We can say that a pro condition of chirality, where these molecules may show pro stereoisomerism, or here we can see topicity relation between these two identical ligands, HA and HB, two identical ligands or two identical groups. We see topicity nature. So here these both are anisotropic. So if we replace HA, then we get a stereoisomer. If we replace this HB, then we get another stereoisomer, and these both stereoisomers will be enantiomers of each other. So these are called anisotropic hydrogen atoms. These both hydrogen atoms are anisotropic. So actually, just by a single substitution, these may show stereoisomers. So it is the initial condition of these stereoisomers. So here we call a term pro stereoisomers. So here this pro term is included, extra term, that is the previous initial condition where just we can introduce chirality in this molecule or on this carbon atom. So here it is shown a base dash configuration, here it is a Fischer projection. So this is a prochiral carbon. Now what we are to do in this part, we have to provide descriptor, pro chirality descriptors or pro RS configuration for these prochiral centers or prochiral carbons. In a prochiral molecule, an atom bearing a pair of anisotropic ligands is called a prochiral center or prochirality center. If a prochirality center is a carbon atom, then it is called a prochiral carbon. Okay. So how we provide prochirality descriptor to these? The rules are same which we use for the assignment of RS for a chiral center. The rules are same. These are CIP rules. So what we do for these identical ligands, according to their identical ligands, we choose a priority. If we provide RS configuration for HA, then we change our numbering system. If we provide for HB, then also we have to change. So the rule are same which we use in simple priority rule, that are CIP rules. So what we check here, first we check the atomic number of this directly attached atoms to this prochiral center. Okay, it is called as a prochiral center or prochiral carbon. This carbon is prochiral carbon. So obviously the oxygen will get number 1, this carbon will get number 2. Now these both atoms are same, both ligands are same, both are hydrogens. So if we provide the prochirality descriptor with respect to HA, with respect to HA, then we put the it at number 3 and the last one will be 4. Now according to chirality rule, we make a arc from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Okay, if it is clockwise, here it is clockwise, then the prochirality descriptor will be R, but the fourth number substituent is present at this horizontal line, so we change our result, so it is actually S, capital S. So what is the prochirality descriptor? That is pro S for HA. Okay, for HA it is pro S. Now come to the HB. With respect to HB, obviously it will be pro R, just reverse of this, pro R. So the numbering process is same, one number for hydroxyl group, second number for this methyl group, and third number obviously for this HB hydrogen atom, and fourth number for this. Now move 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. The arc direction is anticlockwise, but the fourth number substituent, which is hydrogen, is present on this horizontal line, so we change our result, so it is R. So the prochirality descriptor for HB is pro R. Now the pro RS configuration or pro chirality descriptors for prochiral axis and prochiral planes. Prochiral axis, that axis where if we substitute one ligand in the both identical ligands, then we get chiral axis. So here we can see that these HA and HB both are identical ligands. If we substitute these ligands, any one ligand, then we get from other moiety, then we get chiral axis. So it is this axis actually here a chiral, prochiral axis. So how we do its descriptor, how we assign its descriptor, just the rules are same which we have used for chiral axis. What we do that we put these planar portion upside and this wedge dash portion downside. Now we move this molecule like this. Now this goes to downside and this becomes an top side. Now this chlorine goes to at this left hand side, bromine goes to right hand side in this representation, and this VH portion, which is HA, and this dash portion HB will be right as shown on this screen. Okay, this is the same method which we used for in chiral axis for the description or for the assignment of RS descriptor for the chiral axis, the same method. Now what we do, first we assign priority order for wedge dash only we use wedge dash. In wedge dash both are same, both are hydrogens, but here we are assigning the chirality descriptor with respect to HA. With respect to HA, so HA will be provided the number 1, HB number 2. Now we move for this horizontal portion. Okay, here also you have to remind that it is not Fisher projection, it is a method to solve the chirality descriptor or prochirality descriptor for this chiral axis. Now obviously bromine will get third number because it has higher atomic number compared to chlorine, and fourth number this chlorine atom. Now move from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, make arc 1 to 2, 2 to 3. So it is obviously anti-clockwise direction. So what we get, pro s, and we don't change our result in chiral axis in pro chiral axis. The rule is different and we don't change our result. We don't see this horizontal or vertical sides. So this S with respect to the HA ligand, this chiral pro chiral center or sorry pro chiral axis, this pro chiral axis, this pro chiral axis has pro S chirality descriptor, pro S chirality descriptor. Obviously this HB will have pro R. Okay, so for this it is pro S and for HB it is pro R. So we can see here, just move this from this to this side, HA goes to left hand side, HB goes to right hand side, this chlorine goes to on wedge on top side, and this bromine goes to on wedge dash and below side. Now what we do, we provide this numbering according to atomic number, first only for wedge dash portion, bromine gets 1, chlorine gets 2. Now we are doing this prochirality descriptor with respect to HB. Okay, with respect to HB, so obviously this HB will get number 3 and this number 4. Now move from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, we get this clockwise movement of this arc, so it is pro R. So the pro chirality descriptor for this chiral axis with respect to HB, with respect to HB ligand or HB group or HB atom is pro R. Now the pro chiral plane, a plane on which if we made substitution on any one hydrogen atom in place of these two atoms, any one atom, then we get chiral plane. But in this case, in this molecule where it contains a plane of symmetry, here a plane of symmetry, so this molecule actually optically inactive or achiral. So these both hydrogen atoms or both ligands are we can say that anisotropic relation, both have anisotropic relation. So how we make this descriptor, how we provide descriptor? So for HB, the movement like this, the method is same which we use for chiral plane. We move from ring side to substituent side, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. So the direction of arc is clockwise manner, so it is pro R. With respect to HB, with respect to HB ligand, this pro chiral plane has pro chirality descriptor which is pro R, and with respect to HA it is pro S. Okay, so the these type of topicity descriptors could also be assigned for these faces, faces which are generally anisotropic faces. Okay, the anisotropic faces. So here in this carbonyl compound where these both groups R1 and R2 are different, so actually this face means the pi orbital. Pi orbitals in top side and bottom side or upside or below side of this molecular plane is called face. These are two faces of these pi orbitals or pi bond. So if we see from this side or if we see from another side of this molecular plane, then the configuration or we can say the Kelty descriptor will be different. If we observe from this side, okay, or if from this side, one will be sinister or SI face and another other one is rectus or RE face. So these are the assignment of these faces, okay, RE and SI. So how we do that? Suppose if we imagine this molecule like this, suppose this is R1 or this is R2, which is ethyl and methyl substituents, and this is carbonyl group. So how we assign this topicity descriptor to these faces? Obviously here the attached atoms to this face is oxygen. This here, this is carbon, which is a complete group as a ethyl group and this methyl group. Obviously this oxygen will get 1, this ethyl group will get 2, and this methyl group carbon will 3. So the movement is 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. So how we get it is clockwise manner. Here we are getting clockwise manner. So it is RE phase. From which side we are viewing the phase, that matters. It is RE phase. But if we go the back side of this molecule and observe this molecule, so it will observe like this. So obviously this face will be SI face or sinister face. Now again the assignment of pro S or pro R for this molecule. Okay, this carbon is pro chiral carbon, where though both substituents are exactly same, both are chlorine atoms. So is it pro S or is it pro R? How we will assign? So here we can see that it is a Weiss dash representation, and we have to use the same rules which we used in CIP nomenclature. So to assign this pro S or pro R, we put this methyl group, which is lowest priority group in this pro chiral center. The four groups are chlorine, methyl, and this isopropyl. So these both in these four groups, this methyl group has lowest priority. So it will put behind the page because it is lowest priority. So when we put it behind the page, we have to rotate this bond, carbon-carbon single bond, like this. Then this chlorine atom goes to this side, and this wedge dash. Chlorine will move at this side, and we observe this structure. This chlorine, which is marked as star, goes to this side, and this chlorine, and obviously at this dash portion here, we can observe this dash. On this dash, this methyl group goes. Now, how we make numbering? For this chlorine atom which is starred, we have to provide according to or with respect to this starred chlorine atom, we will give it number 1, then this second chlorine atom number 2, then in isopropyl group number 3, and this methyl group number 4. Then move from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, the movement is anticlockwise, that is anti-clockwise manner. So the chlorine atom which is without star will get pro s configuration. Okay, let me see again. Assignment this CL, the result is pro s. Okay, here a printing mistake is present. Here it is not pro r, it is pro s. Okay, so this, with respect to this chlorine atom which is starred, this chlorine atom which is starred, obviously with respect to this, the prochirality descriptor for this prochiral carbon atom or prochiral center is pro s. So this is the description about what is pro stereoisomerism and how we provide the chirality descriptor, prochirality descriptor to these prochiral centers. So thank you for listening this lecture.